Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how you can add options to your website kit's drop-down menu. Now before we do that though, we need to talk about the relationship, or actually the lack of relationship, between drop-down items in those menus and between the book pages in your website. So here we have an example of a typical book page in one of our website kits, and as you can see, we have this parent page called services, and then we have all of these sub pages or child pages, and you're probably very accustomed to this format by now. But one thing you need to understand is that the book page system is actually separate from the drop down system. And while that may not make sense to you right now, it actually is by design. And for many of you, this has turned out to be a blessing in disguise, because one of the questions that I commonly get is, can we choose which items go into the drop-down menus, or are they automatically generated? And the answer is you choose. Unlike book pages, which automatically add themselves to the hierarchy and to the navigation and the breadcrumbs and all that, book pages are not automatically added to drop-down menus. You get to decide that. So if there are things that you don't necessarily want in those drop-down menus, that's great, because you're going to be able to decide which those are. On the other hand, if you want all of the book pages in a particular section to be in a drop-down menu, that's fine too. You just have to add them. So you can have it either way. So it really is by design, so that you have more options. So let's go ahead and create a new option. Let's go back up here to the menu, and let's go ahead and create some drop-down options for services. I'm mousing over it right now, and you can see that there's nothing there. So let's add book discussion kits to this option here, so that when we mouse over services, we're going to get book discussion kits as a sub option. The first thing we want to do is we want to go up to our main navigation, and of course I'm assuming that you're logged in. Click Manage Main Menu. And then you come to this page. Now, this kind of formatting and interface you're probably pretty used to by now. You've certainly seen it whenever you've reorganized the books or the sections of your website. So when we've gone to books in the past to organize the sections, you've seen this very similar drag and drop interface. All of the options have these little drag and drop arrows. Now, we want to add something here. So we're going to go ahead and click Add Link. So I'm clicking that. Okay, so now we're going to give it a title. So we're going to go ahead, let's see, this was called Book Discussion Kits, I think. And then we have to give it the path. And let me go back there to services and grab that and see what it was. Okay, so Book Discussion Kits. I'm going to go ahead and copy that link address from that link there, from the book page, and I'm going to go ahead and paste it. But let's talk a little bit about what we're pasting here, because I want to make sure that you don't do something like what I just did. When I copied and pasted it, I actually get the full or absolute URL. An absolute URL is anytime you're including a full URL that has http://yada yada yada. We don't want that. In this case, I'm actually working on a sandbox site, and you can actually see that in the URL, that this is at sandbox.opland.org. And we don't want that, because when I do that, that means that link is going to try to go back to the sandbox when it's actually clicked in the real deal, when we move this site over to a production server. Even though your site probably is not on a production server, it is still very poor practice to put in the full URL unless there's a very good reason. And most of the time, simply isn't. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and get rid of everything that's in that base URL, so that it is essentially just content/book discussion kits. And you'll notice that I also got rid of the /before content. Get rid of that also when you're working with these paths in your website kit. I don't need to do anything else here. The description is simply an internal field that you can use. You're going to want to keep it enabled. It's clicked by default because you want it to be listed in a menu. Now, here's where you can do some other things. We're not going to click Show as Expanded. The vast majority of you would not want this option. But here is where we start telling it, okay, where do we put this link? So I do want it in the main menu. That's what it's going to give you as default. But you can also give it a weight, and you'll remember that from doing book pages. But you know what we're going to do? We're going to make this even easier on ourselves. I'm going to simply leave it at main menu. And if it isn't at main menu, make sure it is. I'm going to leave the weight at 0, and I'm going to go ahead and click Save. And I click Save. And once I do that, it shows up down here at the bottom. And you might be thinking, but I don't want it to be on par in the menu with About Us and Services. It's supposed to go under Services. Well, remember, we've got these handy drag and drop options. So I'm going to go ahead and drag it there underneath. Oops. Yep. And then over one. So I drag it up and over one. And now I'm going to go ahead and click Save Configuration. And now I'm going to go back and refresh this page here so that we can see our drop down. Now when I mouse over Services, we have one option for book discussion kits. So that's how you can get something into the menu. Now you can also remove things and rearrange things. So for example, if you suddenly wanted book discussion kits to be on par with Services, you could just drag it over and now it's going to be on the main menu. But big caveat here, folks, don't do this. Why? Because your main menu is actually designed for a certain number of options. Now that number is slightly different from library to library. It depends on your design. If you put too many things into that top level menu, and when we're talking about the top level menu, I'm talking about this main menu here that runs across the top, it means that you may end up with things being shoved down to what is essentially an imaginary second row, and you're going to have some major display problems. You can probably go with one or two fewer, but adding more can often cause a great deal of pain. So if you need to add an option to the top level navigation, please contact me, laura@opelin.ohio.gov, or give me a call and we'll talk about how we're going to do that so that your design doesn't freak out when you try to put too many things in there. It doesn't necessarily mean that you can't. But having said all that, here's another thing to know. Usability best practices say that you should have probably no more than 7 options max. And some experts will say you shouldn't have more than 4, believe it or not. So fewer is always better than more. We will not let libraries go beyond 8. And even that's kind of a push because then you start to overwhelm users. So when you're thinking about this top level here, be very careful and think very carefully about what absolutely has to be there. Now, as far as submenus go, like events here, this has one sub-level. So calendar, story times, book discussions, this is one level. Now, there could be more options, say, under story times. Maybe we want to add a preschool story time option and a baby story time option and maybe even a family story time option. You can do that. Your menu is designed to have the top level, that main bar that goes across the top, and then 2 sub-levels, meaning it can have this level that you see here, and then each option in this sub-level can have its own options. That is a grand total of 2 sub-levels. So you can do that if you'd like to. And again, you can simply do that by rearranging things. So we could actually say, for example, put book discussions right here, and this becomes a third level. Events is the first level, book discussions is in the second level, and book discussion kits is in the third level. Don't go farther than that. We cannot guarantee what will happen from a design perspective. It also gets very messy for the user. We do not do designs for more than that simply because it's just not a good idea. So that's how you can add and arrange the items in your menu. If you want to rearrange the items in your main menu, you can do that. So let's say I want to put borrow down here under services. I can do that. Remember though, just like your other drop-down interfaces in your website kit, and this message is always at the top. Changes made in this table will not be saved until the form is submitted. So that means that I can mess with this all I want and change things here, there, and everywhere, but until I click the Save Configuration button at the bottom, nothing is going to happen. Now let's say I want to get rid of this book discussion kits. I can do that simply by going to Delete over here, click Delete. And just like everything else in your kit, it's going to give you that Are You Sure option. And you do have to confirm it. And once you do this, once you click this Confirm, it really is gone. So I'm going to go ahead and get that gone. Now if we go back over here, I'm going to go ahead and refresh this. And now we have no options, nothing that's appearing when we mouse over services. If you have any other questions, feel free to contact me. Also, don't forget that the Dynamic Website Kit Manual here has some screenshots and things to help you along if you're still not sure. And we're always happy to help you. Thanks a lot.